हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज श्रावण। दिस इज माय यूट्यूब चैनल सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाय श्रावण। टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल क्लिक ऑन सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन फॉर मोर इंटरेस्टिंग अपडेट्स। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू एनालिसिस एंड डिजाइनिंग ऑफ G+1 बिल्डिंग विथ सेकेंडरी बीम्स बाय यूजिंग स्टैट प्रो V8S सॉफ्टवेयर। सो जनरली इफ द लोडिंग कंडीशन ऑन दट रिस्पेक्टेड बिल्डिंग इंक्रीजेस, जनरली दे विल गो विथ सेकेंडरी बीम्स फॉर एनालिसिस एंड डिजाइनिंग ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर। ओके, इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द सिंपल प्लान विच इज रिलेटेड टू द G+1 बिल्डिंग। सो आफ्टर एक्सप्लेनिंग द प्लान आई विल कंसिडर द सेकेंडरी बीम्स फॉर दट रिस्पेक्टेड ड्यूप्लेक्स हाउस। ओके, सो गो टू योर PDF फाइल। So this is the simple duplex house plan which is in east facing direction. So this is the ground floor plan and this is the first floor plan. In my upcoming video, I will explain you complete details of this respective duplex house plan. Okay, so it will be consisting of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 number of columns. Okay, so the center to center distance between the first column to second column, I will consider it as 3 meter, and second column to third column, I will consider it as 4 meter. In the same way, I will consider the vertical direction, first center to center distance is 3 and second center to center distance is 4. Again, I will consider one more distance is there which is related to your third column to fourth column. Okay, so I will consider that respected distance as 6. Okay, so here the center to center distance between the column is increases from third column to fourth column. Okay, by increasing the center to center distance between the column, the loading condition on this respective slab is also increases. Okay, to decrease that respected values of the load distribution values, generally we will consider the secondary beams for this respected house. Okay, so I will explain you how to consider the secondary beams and how to analyze that respective structure. Okay, for this model I will consider the secondary beams which is at a distance of 1.5 meter from this respected third column. Okay, the remaining distance will be of 4.5, the regular dimensions. Okay, so this is the ground floor plan and this is the first floor plan. Okay, so initially click on the StatPro software. Click on StatPro software here. So here the software will be open like this. Initially click on new project, select the spacing option here. So select the structure name, just I am taking it as ASD something. Save your file location as per your respected location. So here we have to consider the length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button. So click on S option. So here we have to select the add beam command. Click on finish button. Now the software will be open like this. So it will be consisting of same 10 number of grids in horizontal direction, 10 number of grids in vertical direction. So if you want to change this respected grid lines, you can edit with the edit option here. So here I'm simply taking 10 number of grids and 10 number of grids in y direction. So for modeling of any kind of the building, initially we need to go to geometry option here. So here we have to select the run structure wizard option. So it will be consisting of different types of models here. In this we have to select the frame models initially. So here I am selecting the bay frame. Why? Because due to the presence of the fixed supports at the base. Okay, so here as per the plan, just I am considering length of the building will be consisting of 7. Okay, again we have to consider the height. Initially I will consider the first story. So after modeling process completed for the first story, I will consider the remaining story. So here I am taking the height of the building is 3. So after that we have to take the width of this respective structure. So width is equals to 3 + 3 + 6, which is equals to 12 meter. Okay, so after that we have to enter the number of base along length direction or 2. Again we have to enter the number of base along height direction or 1 and number of base along width direction or 3. Okay, so after that we have to select this respected lines here. So it will be consisting of this respected 3, 3.5. so initially we need to take the value as 3 for the first bay and second bay will be of 4. Okay, click on OK here. So after that we have to enter the values which are related to the width. Okay, so initially we have to select these 3 dots. Just I am entering the first bay length will be consisting of 6 here. Again second bay length will be consisting of 3 here. Again third bay length will be consisting of 3. Click on apply here. So after that click on apply. Now we can see the model of this respected duplex house ground story was open here like this, which is consisting of beams as well as columns grid lines. Now we have to import this respected model from structure wizard to StatPro software. Click on cancel. Click on yes button. Click on OK. Now the model is imported to the StatPro software. So after that we have to keep the structure in 3D view. For this respected building, it will be consisting of the center to center distance between the third column to fourth column is 6 meter. Due to presence of the extra center to center distance between the columns, generally the loading distribution will be more for this respected top portion. Okay, so to decrease that respected portion intensities, initially we need to add the secondary beams here. Okay, generally secondary beams also called as zero beams. Okay,
So initially I am selecting this respected options. Okay, so click on insert a node. Just I am taking insert a node point. So here we have to take the node point distances here. So here I am taking it as 4 from this respected point. Click on OK. So it will insert a node point at this respected position here. So after that we have to connect this respected portion with the help of secondary beams. So for that, select add beam command. Select the first point here, select the second point here, select the third point here, select the fourth point. Okay, now the secondary beam was added for this respected portion here like this. Okay, so after that we have to model the staircases for this portion. Okay, so now we have to select the top view. Again I am selecting cut section command, click on select to view, click on OK. So here I am cutting this respected portion here like this. Now initially we have to select this beam, so click on insert a node. We have to insert a node point at midpoint. Click on OK. So it was inserted a node point here like this. So after that we have to select the node cursor, select this node, click on copy option, again click on paste nodes, which is at z of -1. So click on OK. Again I am selecting the paste nodes, which is z of -2 here. Okay, now just I am selecting the 3 node points, click on copy here, click on paste nodes here. In x direction distance, just I am considering it as 0.75 here. So click on OK. So it will create this respected portion here like this. So after that we have to connect this respected beams with the help of cantilever beam. So we have to connect this beam here like this. Now we have to model the slab. So select add 4 node plate, select first point, select second point, select third point, again I am selecting the fourth point. Okay, so after that we have to copy this respected node points to the x direction distance in the same way. So for that, select the node cursor here, select this, just I am selecting this node point, just select this node point, click on copy, click on paste nodes. Again we have to select the z direction distance, which is consisting of -1 here. Click on OK. Again in the same way, just I am selecting this node, click on copy option, again click on paste nodes. Again I am selecting the z direction distance of -1 here. Click on OK. So after that we have to connect this respected node points with the help of slab. So select this respected add 4 node plate option, select the first point, select the second point, select the third point, again come to the first point. In the same way we have to connect to the top portion here. Okay, so now here we are modeled with staircases. So click on host Hatcher command here. So after that we have to add the slab section for this respected portion. Okay, so before adding the slab section, initially we need to create the node point at this portion. So click on insert a node at midpoint, click on OK. Now we have to select the add 4 node plate option. Okay, select the first point, again select the second point, again select the third point, again select the fourth point. In the same way we have to create the slab section for the right hand side section here. So here I am selecting first point, second point, third point, fourth point. Again I am selecting the, here we have to select this respected portion here. Select the first point, second point, third point, fourth point. Again I am selecting first point, second point, third point, fourth point. Select first point, second, third, fourth. Again I am selecting the first point here. Select the second point here. Select the third point here. Again select the fourth point. In the same way we have to connect to the remaining node points here like this. Okay. Now we can see building was modeled here like this. So after that we have to select this node point, click on delete option, click on S option. Okay, so after that we have to see this model in rendering view. So click on 3D rendering view option. So this is a 3D rendering view for this respected structure with the secondary beams. So for this respected staircases also we have to add with the secondary beam for the portion of slab. So select add beam. So here we have to select this section. Okay, so after that we have to create the one more story for this respected structure. So initially we have to select Ctrl A option for selection of all the beams, go to transitional repeat here, Y direction, number of steps are 1, each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Again we have to select the slab section, Ctrl A. Again we have to select the transitional, Y direction, number of steps are 1, each step will be consisting of 3 meter here. Okay, so after creating the first story, we have to add the properties for this building. So select the general option, click on define option. Initially I am selecting the rectangular section, which is consisting of 0.23 grass, 0.3 is the beam size for the primary section. Again I am adding the secondary beam size, which is consisting of 0.23 grass, 0.23. generally the size of the secondary beam will be reduces for the building sections. Okay, so here I am selecting the column section, which is consisting of 0.3 grass, 0.3. click on add button, close option, select the thickness here. So here I am selecting plate thickness, which is consisting of 125 mm, add button, close option. So initially I am selecting the columns here. Go to select option, beams parallel to Y condition. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. Again I am selecting the plate thickness by using assign to view, assign yes option. Now we have to select the beams here, which is related to the primary section. Select this beam. Again I am selecting the beams, select option, parallel to X condition. Again I am selecting the beams, parallel to second Z axis. Okay, so after selecting these respective beams, we have to deselect the secondary beams. Okay, so here I am deselecting all my secondary beams. So click on assign to selected beams here, assign yes. So after that we have to select the secondary beams. So click on select option, missing attribute by missing property. Click on assign to selected beams option, assign yes option. So after that we have to see this respected whole model in rendering view again. So click on the rendering view option. So this is the rendering view for this respected structure. It will be consisting of 0.23 cross 0.3 is the column size, 0.23 cross 0.3 is the beam size, and 0.3 cross 0.3 is the column size, and 0.23 cross 0.23 is the secondary beam size, and plate thickness will be consisting of 125 mm. So after modeling process completed, we have to assign the supports for this respective structure. So select the general option, select the supports here, click on create option, add your fixed supports, select your support to, with the help of the front view option, we have to select all the node points at the base. Click on assign to selected nodes, assign yes. So after that we have to add the load cases for this respective structure. So for this respective structure, I will consider the load cases which are related to the dead loading condition, live loading condition, and earthquake loading condition. So I will skip the wind loading condition. Why? Because as per the IS 875 code, it was suggested that if the height of the building is greater than 10 meter, we need to consider the wind load action. So initially I will define the seismic loading condition, select the loads and definition, select the definitions here, select the seismic definition, click on add. Initially we need to select the IS code. So click on generate option. So I am adding the high seismic zone 5 condition, which is related to 0.36, and special RC moment resisting frame with 5, and medium soil condition, damping ratio just I will consider it as 0.05. click on generate here. So after that we have to click on add option. Now we have to select the self weight here, add button. Again we have to select the member weight, which is related to the uniform load. Now we have to calculate the uniform load as per the dimensions. So here I am taking highest beam size, which is consisting of 0.3 cross 0.23. We have to multiply this respected value with 25. So it will give the intensity of 1.725. Click on add here, close option. Select the uniform load. So we have to select the beams parallel to X condition. So here I am selecting X condition. Again I am selecting beams parallel to Z axis. Click on assign to selected beams here, assign yes. So after that we have to define the load case details. Select the load case details here, click on add. Initially we need to define the seismic loading condition, earthquake load, which is in X condition. Again I am selecting earthquake load, which is in Z condition. Now we have to select the dead load. So here I am selecting DL, add. Again I am selecting the live load here, select the title as LL, add, close. Select the earthquake load, which is in X direction condition, click on add. So initially we need to select the seismic loading condition, which is in X condition with the factor 1, add, close. Again I am selecting Z condition. Again select the seismic load here. So we have to select the seismic loading condition in Z condition with the factor 1, add, close. Select the dead load, add here, add your self weight, close option. Select the self weight by using assign to view, assign yes. Again select the live load, add here. Now here I am selecting the floor load. Just I am assuming 2.5 is the floor load intensity. Why? Because this building comes under your residential structure, and the minimum height is 3 and maximum height is 6. Click on add. Again we have to add the load combination. Select the load case details, add. Select the auto load combinations as per the Indian code. Click on generate here, click on add here, click on close. So after that select the materials here, select the concrete material. We have to assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we have to go to analysis and print, add your no print, close option. Go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we have to check for the zero errors for this respected model. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So it was observed zero errors here. Go to post processing mode, click on done. So click on apply here, click on OK. So this is the deflection of the building due to presence of the live loading condition. and dead loading condition and earthquake load X and earthquake load in Z condition. So after that we have to select the beams here. Again I am selecting Fy. So this is the shear force diagram due to presence of earthquake load Z axis, dead load condition, shear force diagram. Select MZ value, deselect the Fy. So this is the bending moment diagram for this respective structure. So after that we have to select the plate load. Apply your stress type as absolute pressure. Click on apply, click on OK. So this is the maximum absolute pressure for this respective structure due to presence of the various types of load cases. So after that we have to design this respective structure. So go to modeling here, select the design option here. Now select the concrete design, select the IS code here, IS 456. So click on select parameters. Initially we have to deselect all selected parameters. From these parameters we have to add compressed strength, yield strength of shear reinforcement, maximum main, maximum secondary. Click on OK. Again click on add option. Initially I am selecting the compressive strength of the concrete is 30,000. Add it. Again I am selecting Fy main. Next I am taking it as 500 grade steel, 500,000. Click on add. Again I am selecting section reinforcement, which is also 500,000. Click on add. Maximum main, just I'm taking it as 16 mm bars. Click on add. Maximum secondary, just I'm taking it as 12 mm bars. Add, close. Now we have to select the commands here. Click on design beam command, add it. Again select the design column, add it. Design slab element command, add it. Take off command, add button, close option. Now we have to select this respected FC value by using assign to view, assign, yes. Again I'm selecting Fy main by using assign to view, assign, yes option. Again I'm selecting Fy section by using assign to view option, assign, yes option. Select maximum main, assign to view, assign, yes. Select maximum secondary, assign to view, assign, yes option. Select design beam command. We have to select the beams parallel to X condition. Again you have to select the beams parallel to Z condition. Click on assign to selected beams, assign, yes. Again I am selecting design column, assign to view, go to select option. We have to select the beams parallel to Y, assign to selected beams, assign, yes. Again I am selecting design element here, assign to view, assign, yes option. So after that go to analysis and print, add your no print again, close option again. Again go to analyze here, run analysis, save it. So here we have to check for the zero errors for this respected design also. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors here. Go to post to processing mode, click on done. So deselect the deflection diagram. So again we have to select the beam, deselect the bending moment diagram, select any one of the beam here. So this time selecting this respected beam, double click on it, click on concrete design. So it will be consisting of 3 bars of 10 mm dia, 200 center to center distance at the top reinforcement, and again it will be consisting of 3 bars of 10 mm dia, 30 center to center distance at the bottom reinforcement. Okay, so again it will be consisting of 18 number of the stirrups, which is having 8 diameter, and center to center distance between the each stirrup is 110 mm. Okay, so after that click on close, select the column, any one of the column, double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is a concrete design for this respective structure. It will be consisting of 4 number of bars of 12 mm size, and AST percentage is 0.5, AST requirement is 354 mm square for the respected M30 grade and FE500 grade steel. So after checking the reinforcement values for the beam section and column section, we have to check the reinforcement values for the secondary beams also. So here I am selecting this first story secondary beam here, double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design for this respected secondary beam. It will be consisting of 3 bars of 10 mm dia, 200 center to center distance at the top reinforcement. Again it will be consisting of 3 bars of 10 mm dia at the bottom reinforcement. These reinforcement values are similar to that of the primary reinforcement, but the stirrups values are varying here. Okay, so here it will be consisting of 16 number of stirrups for this length of the beam, and it will be consisting of center to center distance is 90. For the primary beam section it will be consisting of 18 numbers, and 114 is the center to center distance. Okay, so this is the only difference between the primary beam section as well as secondary beam section. So after that we have to see the start output file here. So click on start output file here. So click on the results option. So click on the concrete design. So this is the concrete design for each and individual calculations as per your considerations of grade of concrete and grade of steel here. Okay, so after that we have to design the foundation. So select the foundation design. So initially we need to select the load cases which are related to the seismic load and dead load, live load. Include here, click on run STAAD foundation. The fixed supports of this respected foundation will be directly imported to the STAAD software. So here the software is opened with fixer supports here like this. So initially we need to select the load generation here. So click on generate load combinations. So now we have to select the Indian code. So click on generate load combinations as per the service load combination. Again click on generate load combinations as per the ultimate load combination. So after that we have to select the job setup, create job. So initially we need to give the job name. Just I'm taking it as A, isolated footing. Again I'm selecting as per the Indian system and SI units, and we have to select the load cases which are related to 101, 102, 201, 202, 203, 204. Include this, click on create job. So it will create the isolated footing job here like this. Select the place mark here, click on design here, click on S button. So it will design the isolated footing design results as per the IS-456-2000 code. So these are the foundation design results. Select any one of the footing. So this is the each and individual calculation part for this respected foundation. Click on starting page, click on geometry, click on details and drawing. So this is the details and drawing, click on GA drawing. This is the calculation sheet. This is the process analysis and designing of G+1 duplex house with the secondary beams by using StatPro V8A software. Thank you.